Any NumPy array has a number of attributes that describes it, in addition to the elements it contains. One of the most useful one is shape. Essentially, a tuple containing the number of rows and columns or height and width of the array. We have already seen how to specify this when creating arrays. The shape of the array A would be 5 rows and 4 columns. So this is your array. Now let's see how to access the shape of the given array by using the shape attribute. A.shape will give you the shape of the array. Let's run it. Array.shape will return you a tuple with the first value specifying the number of rows and the second value specifying the number of columns. Next, we will learn how to individually access number of rows or number of columns. A.shape 0 would return the number of rows and A.shape 1 would return the number of columns. Let's check the output. Here you see that the number of rows are correctly extracted as 5 and number of columns as 4. If you have more dimensions, you will have additional elements in the shape tuple. The number of dimensions in an array can be found by simply asking for the length of this tuple. A.shape will return a tuple and the length of that tuple would inform us what is the dimension of the array. It rightly tells us that the dimension of the defined array A is 2. Okay, how about total number of elements in an array? Yes, for a 2D array, it will be the product of number of rows and columns. But if you had more dimension, this calculation could be a little complicated. Fortunately, we can retrieve the number of elements directly using size attributes. A.size will give us the number of elements present in the array A. We can expect the output to be the product of the rows and the columns, which is 5 into 4, which is 20. Let's check it. As we expected, the output is 20, which means there are 20 values in the array. Attributes like size and shape are very useful when you have to iterate over array elements to perform some computation. You can also access the data type of each element using the dtype attribute of the array. Let's check the data type of the values present in array A. In this case, our array elements are of the type float 64, that is 64-bit floating point numbers.